Good morning to all. Let us join our hands, close our eyes, open our inner eyes to see the Lord present within us. He is looking at us lovingly. Let us gaze at Him. Loving Lord, we thank and praise You for this beautiful day You have blessed us with. Thank You for sending Your divine Son, Jesus, in this sinful world to save us. Though You were God, You made Yourself small like us in order to raise us up to You. Thank You for this immense love in being born in this world. We ask You, Lord, to fill this world with Your love once again, so that mankind learn to live in peace and loving relationship with all. May Your birth remind us that You still love the world and taking care of us all. Heal the world, Lord, we implore, from further harm due to pandemic. May all experience Your care and love. We pray that may the birth of Jesus bring joy, hope and love in our hearts, and peace and brotherhood upon the earth. We ask for the salvation of all our family members and friends, and we pray Your blessings on all people. May there be bread for the hungry, love for the unlovable, healing for the sick, protection for our children, comfort for the afflicted, and wisdom for our youth. We pray for the forgiveness of sinners and abundant life in Christ. Holy Spirit, fill our hearts with Your love and power. May the light of Christmas shine in our hearts. In the name of Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.
It's Christmas Day, it's Christmas Day. Let's celebrate it in a beautiful way. It's Lord Jesus' birthday. The Word came to earth to take our pain and sins away. He took the hardships of our life to make us intelligent and wise. On Christmas, Santa Claus comes at midnight to give us gifts which are beautiful and bright. Gifts of Santa Claus gave us a peace which brings smile on children's face. Let's enjoy the Christmas and the snowfall. The Lord is very kind and does good for all.
Good morning to one and all. I am Gorangi and she is Dia. Today, we are celebrating the auspicious day of Christmas. Do you know why we celebrate Christmas and what does it mean?
Yes. Christmas is celebrated on 25th December every year. It is a season of joy, peace and happiness. It is a special season set aside to celebrate the birth of Jesus Christ. People believe that Jesus is the Son of God. Jesus was born to Mary in Bethlehem. Christ is the center of Christmas. He is the reason for the season.
Okay, you explained it very nicely. His birth was God's miracle. He was sent by God to save mankind. God sent His only Son to save them and to give them eternal life.
Christmas reminds us of the importance of giving and sharing with family and friends. It's a message of great joy, love, peace and salvation. It's a joyous time for many as they give thanks to God for His infinite love and mercy.
Yes, you're right. When we celebrate the birth of Jesus, let's make sure that He is not born only in the crib, but also in our hearts. I think on this day, we should gift people with our forgiveness, charity and respect to set an example for everyone.
So you see, Christmas is not just about gifts and food. It is about the birth of Jesus Christ. And most importantly, it's time to spend time with your family and friends. Love and forgive everyone and thank God for whatever He has given us. Thank you.
Christmas season is finally around us, and the lights, trees, and cheer are all over. There's no better time of the year. Few things about this season to get you more excited are: first, giving presents. A Christmas gift or a present is given in the celebration of Christmas. The practice of giving gifts according to Christian tradition is a symbol of the presentation of gifts given by the three wise men to the infant Jesus. Second, decorating up a Christmas tree. There's nothing more exciting to go and pick up a Christmas tree and gathering around with people with whom you love to add all the lights and the ornaments. Third, carols and music. Christmas carols are special songs which are sung during the Christmas season. The songs are all about Jesus and the time when He was born. Just like Jingle Bells, Winter Wonderland, and many more. Fourth, time with family and friends. Friends and family are fantastic, and this is the time to gather and remember how lucky we are to have people around us who love us the most.
Oh, finally, the class is over.
Don't you think all this is too much? Studies are also not happening, everybody is stuck at home, and so many of our loved ones are sick. Is God not seeing all this? How are we going to get out of all this? I'm so worried and fed up.
What you're saying is so right, but don't you remember we were taught that God had promised a Savior who will save us from all hardships?
In the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent by God to a town in Galilee called Nazareth to a virgin named Mary, who was engaged to a man called Joseph of the house of David, and he came to her and gave her the good news.
Greetings, favored one. The Lord is with you.
Who is this man and what sort of greeting this might be?
Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God.
Lord, I am afraid, but I do not understand your words.
You will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you will name him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High, and the Lord God will give to him the throne of his ancestor David. He will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there will be no end.
How can this be, since I am a virgin?
The Spirit of the Lord will come upon you, and the power of the Almighty will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God. For unto you will be born a Savior for the whole world, to save the world from the clutches of the evil.
Seeing that Mary was still confused, the angel proclaimed,
"Nothing is impossible for God. You see, your relative Elizabeth, in her old age, has also conceived a son, and this is the sixth month for her who was said to be barren."
Knowing this, Mary fell on her knees and proclaimed her faith, saying,
"Behold the handmaid of the Lord, be it done unto me according to your word."
This was the incident of the annunciation of the coming of the Lord of the entire humanity, who was to bring salvation to all. And the day of His arrival is what we call the Nativity, Christmas. This was the day we were promised the salvation from all kinds of bondage of sin, hardships, and adversities. For it is said, "Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord." Therefore, there is no way God is going to leave us astray. He will always hold us in the palm of His hand and protect us from all difficulties.
the mountain, over the hills and everywhere. Go tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is born. The shepherds kept them watching for silent flocks by night. Behold,
the road to Bethlehem. It was a long journey that day, through winding roads and forest ways. On a cold winter night came a young woman, Mary, to Bethlehem. She cried in labor pain, looking to lay her young one in vain. Joseph, her betrothed, found a shed in sight to spend the entire night. A son came into their life as animals in the shed cried out in delight. The new guest lying in the manger was no ordinary child. The neighs of horses, the bleat of sheep, the moos of cows all filled the air around the manger on Bethlehem's first Christmas night.
Aaj sabhi gaaye Savior is born. Wonder who this child is? Some say King, the Prince of Peace, and some Emmanuel. Dressed in a swaddling cloth, before him the heavens will bow. As the child lay quiet that night, a star appeared on the sky shining bright. Nobody thought it was a sign, except for three wise men who found it divine. They followed the star bright and came to Bethlehem's silent night. Worshipping their king, gold, incense and myrrh they bring. Angels appeared to the shepherds and said, "Go visit the Savior lying in the shed." Around the baby were shepherds, kings and heavenly choir that began to sing. Wondered Joseph and Mary, what will he be? God's only son chosen to change man's destiny.
A reading from the Gospel of St. Matthew, chapter 2, verses 1 to 11. Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen a star in the east, and are come to worship him." When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. Then Herod, when he had privily called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem, and said, "Go and search diligently for the young child, and when you have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also." When they had departed the king, they departed, and lo, the star, which they saw in the east, went before them till it came and stood over the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceedingly great joy. When they come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold, frankincense and myrrh. This is the word of the Lord. Praise be to you, O Lord Jesus Christ.
Warm morning to all. It's that time of the year when you hear jingling bells, Santa's hearty laugh, sing carols under the dreamy mistletoe, and it's all joy to the world. Yes, it's Christmas time. And so we have for you a fun-filled Christmas surprise. So strap yourself in, because we are going for a joyride. But before anything, I would like to request our principal, Sister Mallika, to grace us with her wise words.
Good morning, dear children and teachers. The birth of Jesus Christ is celebrated as Christmas on 25th December. In Jesus, God has taken the form of man, and He is God with us. Jesus came to save us from our sins and gave us back our status of children of God. On Christmas, we share this good news with our family, friends, neighbors. We are precious in the eyes of God, no matter what caste or creed we belong to, no matter whether we are rich or poor. He accepts us as we are. Christmas symbolizes the significance of life. He was born in a world that only knew greed, hatred, vengeance, and hypocrisy. In spite of all the negativity that was spreading around the world, as He grew old, He eliminated all of it and taught everyone to love each other. He came to show what life is and its worth. Life is not for enjoyment in worthless living. Life is to live for others. Jesus was born in a cave where animals lived. Since Joseph found no place in the dwellings of the human for Mary to give birth to Jesus, yet He loved all, lived and died for all. Though He was rich, Lord of heaven and earth, He was born in poverty. Though He was the King of the universe, He lived like the poor. Having all, He gave up all. He lived simple life of a carpenter, worked hard for living. He owned no house, no money, yet He won the hearts of all. His life attracted many. His life was spent for the well-being of human persons without counting the cost. This day is truly a blessing as Jesus Christ re-established the relationship of love and forgiveness. Let us share the love, kindness, and forgiveness of Jesus with our neighbors and whomever we meet along our journey of life. May this Christmas be a blessing to all. God bless you. Merry Christmas.
Thank you, sister, for enlightening us and making us realize the true essence of Christmas. On this note, let's now go and check what's wrong with my friend Nanya. She's been cribbing about something all week. Hey, why are you crying?
I did not get iPhone 13 Pro. All of my friends have it by now. They make me jealous by sending ultra clear pictures of their food.
Oh God, is this even a thing to crib about?
Yes, yes, it is. What? You have everything. Please give me this one gadget.
Oh, you wish. God isn't a wishing factory. And you're certainly not Cinderella with a fairy godmother.
But wouldn't life be easier if I were in a Mary Poppins movie or I had Nanny Maxie in my life? Or what if I was Harry Potter?
If you were Harry Potter, one thing I know for sure, you would never keep that wand down. But it's no time to be sad and gloomy. This is a season to be jolly. So, you better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Christmas time is coming around. With that being said, Holy Child School has a whole fun program awaiting us. All the events in this list excite me. I'm dying to see how they're going to be.
Me too. They are so glamorous. But before starting with anything, we need to seek for God's blessings and ask for His acknowledgement throughout the program. So, before you, we present the students, under the guidance of Miss Sri Lakshmi with their auspicious prayer dance.
शरण तिहारे आए,
शरण तिहारे आए।
हे परमेश्वर, हे प्राणेश्वर,
हे परमेश्वर, हे प्राणेश्वर,
नमन करें हम स्वामी, शरण तिहारे आए,
शरण तिहारे
मालिक, तू है स्वामी, तू इस जग का विधाता,
तू है मालिक, तू है स्वामी, तू इस जग का विधाता।
तुझको पाए, तुझको निहारे, जीवन में सुख पाए,
जीवन में सुख पाए,
शरण तिहारे आए,
शरण तिहारे
आए। Performance was breathtaking. Wow, thank you ma'am for making us feel the presence of Lord. What is next?
It is aptly said that the kingdom of God belongs to children. And now we have two flowers from his garden, Angeline Kaur of the first day and Miraya Sethi of second day, who will spread their love and fragrance.
Did the skies were born for you and me, to save us all from temptation that we might all be free. On Christmas Day, we celebrate the birthday of Jesus Christ, also known as Isu Masih. He is the Son of God. He was born in a manger. On this day, people decorate their home, Christmas tree, and the celebration is empty without carols and cake. People believe Santa Claus comes on Christmas Eve to give gifts. You better watch out. You better not cry. Better not pout. I'm telling you why. Jesus Christ is coming to town. Jesus is the reason for this season. Merry Christmas to everyone! Ho, ho, ho!
Thank you for giving us a great joy because we celebrate the birth of a little baby boy. December 25 is no ordinary day because it celebrates the birth of Lord Jesus Christ. When Joseph and Mother Mary arrived in the city of Bethlehem, the inn had no rooms, so they were offered a stable where baby Christ was born. Lord Jesus Christ had a perfect and sinless life, and he was sent to the earth to save the mankind on Christmas. We sing Christmas carols. Away in a manger, oh come on ye faithful, joy to the world the Lord is come. On Christmas there are gatherings of friends and family, lighting on Christmas tree, and Santa Claus bringing presents for us. Christmas is a festival of joy and happiness. Merry Christmas to you all. Thank you.
Thanks, Atan, Angeline, and Miraya for your special words. What could be next now? They said there is so much suspense and surprise. That's really exciting.
You said God has everything. Means like a palace of gold, silk sheets, expensive china, and all things luxurious?
Yes, my grandma says he has everything and he does everything.
But do you know how Jesus Christ was born and how he lived his life?
He was the Son of God, so maybe he was fed in a silver spoon and lived in a palace of gold.
Irony there. The Prince of Heaven and God's own Son was born in the most modest of places, amongst the ordinary folk. But I myself don't know the complete story. And so to help us both, we have a nativity play coming up now.
But 2000 years ago, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin named Mary, who was pledged to be married to a carpenter named Joseph.
Greetings, Mary. You are highly favored, and the Lord is with you.
What do you want? Why have you come to see me?
Do not be afraid. You have found favor with God and will conceive and give birth to a son. You will call him Jesus.
How is that possible? I'm a virgin.
The Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the Holy One to be born will be called the Son of God.
I serve the Lord. May His will be done.
Joseph, Mary's betrothed, found out Mary was pregnant before they came together. Because he loved her, yet still believed she had been unfaithful, he decided to divorce her quietly so that she would not be in disgrace. But before he could, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream.
Joseph, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife. Her child was conceived from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. Everyone was required to go to their hometown to register. So Joseph took Mary, who was with child, on the hard journey to Bethlehem to register. When Mary and Joseph arrived, they looked for a place to stay.
What do you want?
My wife is about to give birth and we need a place to stay.
There are no rooms left.
What do you want? Can't you see how crowded the city is? Please. Help us. I need a warm place to have my child.
There's a stable nearby. You can stay there.
Okay, thank you.
The time soon came for the baby to be born. Mary gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger.
because there was no guest room available for them.
I will call him Jesus. He will save his people from his sins.
Yes, he is the promised Messiah, the Son of God.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified.
Who are you? And why are you here?
Go away!
Do not be afraid. I bring you good news that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger.
Is it? The Messiah we have waited for has come?
Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth, peace to those on whom His favor rests." So the shepherds hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who lay in the manger.
We are humbled to look upon our Savior.
Now when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east.
We three kings of Orient are bearing gifts, we traverse afar.
As for the Jews from east, we have traveled a long way, guided by a bright star, to find your child and bring him gift. I brought the gift of gold.
I have brought the child the gift of frankincense.
I have brought the child the gift of myrrh.
Thank you all for these gifts. May the Lord bless you and keep you safe on your journeys. This was the first Christmas. After the wise men had gone, an angel of the Lord appeared to Joseph in a dream and told him to escape to Egypt. There, the Holy Family lived until King Herod was dead. And then they went on to live in a town called Nazareth. Jesus grew in wisdom and stature and in favor with God and man. He was the Son of God, born to save his people by bearing their sins.
Without the play, I wouldn't have understood these principles of kindness, compassion, generosity with such crystal clear clarity. I thank all those who were involved in such a beautiful play to open up hearts and minds of children like me. What could await us next?
Wait, loads are still left. At Holy Child, we believe in always more and always better. So here are students from the primary section singing carols to bring in the feel of Christmas.
Listen.
mesmerized. Now Shalinga and Yana Lutra of 3rd B would delight us with something special.
Christmas is snow. Christmas is light. Christmas is home. And candles bright. A pound of fun and a pound of joy. Make a nice present for a girl or a boy. Santa granted your wishes and gave you what you asked. A cup of goodness and a cup of love, really a gift from heaven above. A pinch of honey and a pinch of pie. Now we know it's Christmas time. Merry Christmas!
Good morning, everybody. Christmas marks the celebration of birth of Lord Jesus Christ. It is mainly celebrated by the Christians, but it is also celebrated by other communities all over the world. People decorate their homes and area nearby with decorated pine trees and colorful lights. The most enthusiastic part of Christmas are the children, who eagerly wait for this day throughout the year. Jesus Christ is the ultimate image of forgiveness. People visit their families, friends and relatives to celebrate this day together. People celebrate Christmas with a great enthusiasm and joy. Jingle bells, jingle bells, jingles all the way. Over fun is to ride in a one-horse open sleigh. Wishing you all a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Awesome! How do these children do this? Christmas just cheers up every gear and wipes off every tear in me. What do I expect next?
Now, as it is well said, poetry is to prose, dance is to walking. This means that as poem expresses feelings, dance drives the soul. So here come the students of HCS trained by Miss Priyanka to touch our souls. Indeed beautiful. I was smitten by the performance.
Let's now have carol specials by the middle school students of HCS.
Yeah.
For the festivity. But what do we have next?
To set the standards high, to increase the festivity to 200%, here comes the teachers of Holy Child School with the melodious carols.
Mother and child, holy infant, so
Always great at everything. They make everything so cheerful, exciting, and bright by their presence. I'm ecstatic and speechless now. When one has attitude of gratitude, then life touches high altitude. I now request Anvya to give the vote of thanks.
On behalf of Holy Child School, I extend my most sincere gratitude to the Almighty God for making today's event a resounding success. With His blessings and grace, we are able to make this event what it was. An event like this cannot happen overnight. The wheels start rolling weeks ago, and we have been fortunate enough to be backed by a team of very provocative and dedicated staff of our institution who are well versed in their job. A special mention to our respected principal, Sister Malika, for being the catalyst that stimulated us to do our best. With a deep sense of appreciation, we thank our loving teachers for their untiring efforts. Finally, I would like to thank our budding rock stars that made this event joyful with their impressive performances. Your days of hard work were evident in your acts. All the programs were very good and were enjoyed by each one of us present here. Thank you.
And don't forget, the virus still exists. It seems to have taken hashtag New Year New Me resolution to heart. So you better take care. And there's this new variant nowadays. What was it again? Hopcorn? Oh no, Macron? No. Omicron. Right. So better take care and enjoy Christmas with your family and friends. Enjoy to the fullest. Just stay away from that Omicron and have lots of macarons. Wishing you a Merry Christmas.